All right, we're going to wrap this up. I'm going to go to my friend Ann Coulter, who is on the line. You know, the first time I absolutely knew that we were sisters with different philosophies was when I read High Crimes and Misdemeanors. How are you, Ann?
Fine, thanks. How are you, Joyce Coffin?
I'm frustrated. I'm angry. I'm sick of Jerry Nadler and Adam Schiff and all the rest of them who don't seem to... Are these guys really lawyers or do they just chase ambulances? Because what are they talking about with the impeachment? Do they know what high crimes and misdemeanors even is?
No, they apparently think it means we think the president is icky.
Exactly.
Which is not technically a grounds for impeachment. As you know from my book, High Crimes and Misdemeanors, this is a term of legal art. It goes back to, you know, the 1600s. We took it from England. And the overall basic idea is corruption of the office. So there are some things that could be crimes. I mean, obviously, character is a big part of it, especially with the president. But there's some things that could be crimes that have nothing to do with, management of the country or public corruption. Bribery is a classic case of a high crime and misdemeanor that's both a crime and a high crime and misdemeanor. And there's some character type things, say, using your intern for oral sex, and lying to the nation about it. That
right.
would be a high crime and misdemeanor. Public drunkenness, for example, that was a classic one. Because it has to do with his service as his or her service as a public official. They've been looking now to bring it forward to this. Looking for Trump, and they can't get anything. other than the fact of their own hysteria.
Mm-hmm.
And that their base wants them to keep talking about impeachment, which, I mean, it's good for Trump. As you and I have discussed, he hasn't been fulfilling his promises, his central campaign promises on immigration. So, you know, enough of his base is demoralized, considering he won the last election with 80,000 votes spread out over four industrial Midwest states. So it's a strange thing to watch this whole presidential election, with both sides doing everything they can to lose. Trump could be beaten, I think, but not if all they're going to do is keep screaming about impeachment and appealing to their hardcore base.
Or keep screaming about race. I mean, it's just tiring.
Yes, no, the Democratic Party's pitch to beat the guy, they want nothing more than to remove Trump from office, whether, you know, by election or impeachment. And their pitch to the public is, which is obviously the only way it's going to happen, a Republican Senate isn't going to impeach Trump because AOC thinks he's icky.
Mm-hmm.
That, again, not a ground for impeachment. So the Democrats' pitch to the American people is, vote for us, we'll call you racist for the next 4 years, or if you don't like that, we'll just have endless hearings so that we can keep denouncing Donald Trump.
Mm. Yeah. Listen.
They're doing nothing. I mean, it's actually playing into Trump's hands. It is very good for Trump. You know, most people, they want easy, pleasant, not easy, but, you know, pleasant lives. They don't want the government making their lives more difficult. They want a booming economy and jobs and less crime. You know, lots of things that could be accomplished if Trump would keep his promises on immigration. But what are the Democrats giving them? Just these endless hearings. What else are you doing for us, I would think the average voter would say.
Exactly. And after watching that, it was a frightening display with Robert Mueller, who obviously was not in control of that report that was written in his name. And it was, I wasn't sad because, this is the man who wanted the job. He stepped into that job, and if he couldn't do it, he should have stepped out of that job, and he didn't. And the people who were manipulating
him. Technically, he looked so, so bad to me. The reason I was sad about it, I mean, you know, old people who should be in his condition should also not be driving cars, but try to take their car keys away.
That's what I said.
I think people in that state don't realize they're in that state. That's why it was so sad to me. But it explained a lot because, you know, I don't care if he's establishment or liberal. He has a there are mistakes in his past.
Yeah.
As I described in my column last week, going after Stephen Hatfield for 6 years for the anthrax mailing, and under his FBI, the indictment of Senator Stevens, no prize, but he was the longest serving Republican senator. Days before his reelection, he lost by 2% of the vote, and then Obama comes in, and Eric Holder goes and moves for a dismissal because the prosecution was so egregiously bad and unfair against Senator Stevens, who unfortunately then died in a plane crash. There are things in his past, but still, that report, the idea that a prosecutor, I mean, think of this, listeners, suppose you didn't do anything, or I don't know, maybe you did, but in this case, we're going to assume you didn't do anything because, wow, both the media and Mueller's independent counsel and the entire swamp have spent now 2.5 years trying to find something with Russian collusion or obstruction of justice. So every day the prosecutor goes out there and accuses you of whatever it is, you know, killing your next door neighbor, is constantly holding press conferences. You did it, you did it, you did it. They gather all their evidence, and they can't find any evidence to even get an indictment to say that you did it. After all of this, and their answer is, well, we haven't exonerated you, Joe Blow, listening, for killing your neighbor. That isn't what prosecutors do. I mean, it's you can't, you know, I don't think you could have much of a secret investigation of the president. So, yes, this is going to be public. But all a prosecutor can do is indict, charge, or not indict and charge.
Exactly. And tell me why the one person who they got a FISA warrant against, Carter Page, has never been indicted of any crime.
Yes, all these people whose names were dragged through the mud, and even given Robert Mueller's, you know, mistakes in his past, this seemed too much and too crazy.
Mm-hmm.
So no, of course, he, as you know, the joke after watching that hearing going around was the only person who hasn't read the Mueller report is Robert Mueller, completely unfamiliar with it. Clearly, this was an investigation being run by his left-wing zealot lawyers, which is why it really makes a difference. I mean, I thought it made a difference, as I wrote in Resistance is Futile. The fact that Mueller hired staff attorneys, or I think technically Weissman was, I believe he was the first hire, and he hired the rest of
exactly.
them, is the Weissman report. But of 17 prosecutors, 14 registered Democrats, no registered Republicans combined have given tens of thousands to the Democratic Party. One, Jeannie Rhee, has worked as a lawyer for Hillary Clinton and the Clinton Foundation. Look, an independent prosecutor, you're not supposed to be hiring prosecutors who hate the president, who hate the target. They're supposed to be impartial gatherers of facts. You know, pursuing the truth, not getting the precedent, and that's what this was.
Right. It's not even that you can prove that there wasn't a bias. It's the appearance of bias that the Department of Justice, you know, claims they use as a guidepost. They didn't use it this time.
No, they certainly didn't, and we have way more than an appearance of bias here when you look at that report. It was sort of stunning. I'm sure you've talked about this already. But that every time the Republicans were magnificent, by the way, it is worth you and I spend enough time bashing Republicans. We have to put in a good word. When I was traveling, so at the time I could only catch, as it was live, bits and pieces of it. But that night, of the hearing, I watched the full hearing straight through. And oh my gosh, Joyce, I have never been, probably not since the impeachment committee against Bill Clinton, I have not been so proud of Republicans. They were bringing out all this really important information that, wow, MSNBC and CNN have completely hidden from their viewers. The evidence of genuine Russian collusion, for example, and I hope I'm not running up into our break, but I think it is very crucial, all this hysteria about the Trump Tower meeting that Don Jr. had. I write about this in my book. Don didn't contact her.
That's right.
He didn't say, hey, Russia, do you have any dirt on Hillary? No, she contacted him. And the day before that utterly useless Trump Tower meeting, that the Russian woman.
Yeah, met with GPS, Fusion GPS.
Yes, the day before.
and the day after.
That's
right.
Now, gosh, that looks suspicious. But despite the fact that the commission of the independent counsel was to look at Russian interference in the election, and oh, there's plenty of interference. It just happened to all come from the Democrats and Clinton. He keeps saying, oh, yeah, that wasn't our job. That wasn't our job. No, their job was to go after 10-year-old crimes having nothing to do with Trump committed by his
Paul Manafort,
the guy who was his campaign manager for 3 months.
Right.
So clearly, Weissman and the rest of the zealots took their mission as bringing down Trump, not at getting to the truth of any foreign interference in our election.
Absolutely. Well, we have run out of time, but Ann, I need you to come back this week because apparently we finally have a judge who rendered a just decision, and they will be able to use money from this Pentagon budget that's about to expire to build a wall. Wouldn't that be a nice change?
He's got to do it, Joyce.
Yeah, he does.
He's got to do it before this election, and then we can stop worrying.
Yeah, well, listen, if he doesn't do it, Tom Tancredo's going to do it. He's already got wall.
I know.
Yeah, it's amazing to me how, you know, here's a former congressman who says, all we got to do is do this, you know, stop
yes.
hemming and hawing. So we'll see. Anyway, I thank you for, you know, getting my message at the very last minute, and I'll contact you, and later on in the week we got to look at the wall. All right.
Excellent.
All right.
Good to talk to you, Joyce.
Thank you so much. The great Ann Coulter. You can check out her website, anncoulter.com, or read her articles on Frontline or anywhere else that is smart enough to print them. Anyway, high crimes and misdemeanors. It's about time that someone gave a briefing to Adam Schiff, Jerry Nadler, and all the rest of these.